Desperate Kaepernick just used everything he had to take Trump down, now he's really in trouble. Cop-hating third-string quarterback Colin Kaepernick is still unemployed and he's still scamming Americans. He spent all summer with his Muslim girlfriend and outspoken radio host Nasa Diab pushing his fake sob story about the NFL being a racist organization for not hiring him, where even enlisted the assistance of the NAACP to push the ridiculous narrative. Despite leading the 49ers to a historic season franchise loss last year, Kaepernick still wants to blame his unemployment on the NFL rather than facing the harsh reality that no one wants him because he's simply a crappy football player. Over the weekend, Kaepernick lawyered up and filed a grievance against the NFL and President Trump, claiming that there's a massive conspiracy between the 32 NFL teams and Trump to keep him off the field. But just 12 hours after filing the paperwork to blame others for his woes, Kaepernick just got hit with even more embarrassing news that's sending his peanut gallery of whining fans into a collective meltdown this week. The Daily Wire reported. Former 49ers second-string quarterback Colin Kaepernick lawyered up over the weekend, and has now filed a grievance claiming all 32 NFL teams conspired to keep him off the field. Kaepernick, and his attorney, celebrity lawyer Mark Geragos, say that all 32 team owners conspired together to deny him a spot in professional football, even though Kaepernick walked away from a one-year option on his contract with the 49ers, and hasn't been an asset to any football team since 2013. NFL owners, the complaint says, have colluded to deprive Mr. Kaepernick of employment rights in retaliation for Mr. Kaepernick's leadership and advocacy for equality and social justice and his bringing awareness to peculiar institutions still undermining racial equality in the United States. Kaepernick contends that it's a statistical impossibility that he has not, so far, obtained gainful employment as a professional football player. In his complaint, Kaepernick also went straight after President Trump, alleging that the president is in on this conspiracy to keep him out of the NFL. Via Daily Wire. The complaint also alleges that President Donald Trump, the executive branch of the United States government, is at the heart of the collective agreement. Kaepernick claims that he's been out of work in response to coercion and calculated coordination from the executive branch of the United States government. According to the Federalist Papers, Kaepernick's latest tantrum will not be going anywhere, as his ridiculous claims completely lack any sort of evidence whatsoever. The Federalist Papers reported. Colin Kaepernick's latest accusations against NFL owners of collusion do not meet the NFL's collective bargaining agreement's conditions for burden or proof. Collusion occurs when two or more teams, or the league and at least one team, Sports Illustrated explained in March, joint to deprive a player of a contractually earned right. Such a right is normally found in the collective bargaining agreement signed by a league and its players' association. For example, the right of a free agent player to negotiate a contract with a team cannot be impaired by a conspiracy of teams to deny that a player a chance to sign. According to the CBA, the fact that NFL teams have declined to offer Kaepernick a contract does not prove collusion. Furthermore, a free agent's playing skills do not represent evidence for collusion. ESPN says that Kaepernick's grievance is vague and unconvincing, blaming President Donald Trump for coercing NFL owners into withholding offers. ESPN reports. The NFL's collective bargaining agreement, which governs such disputes, makes clear that the failure to sign a player is not in itself enough to prove collusion. Instead, it must be combined with evidence that teams entered into an agreement, express or implied, to bar the player's employment. Here's the relevant wording of the CBA's burden of proof for collusion. The failure by a club or clubs to negotiate, to submit offer sheets, or to sign contracts with restricted free agents or transition players, or to negotiate, make offers, or sign contracts for the playing services of such players or unrestricted free agents, shall not, by itself or in combination only with evidence about the playing skills of the players not receiving any such offer or contract, satisfy the burden of proof set forth, but his grievance, filed by attorney Mark Geragos, does not provide any specific evidence of an agreement to collude. It vaguely references NFL general managers who have cited directives from NFL owners to not let Kaepernick so much as practice with an NFL team. It also accuses owners of submitting to the demands of President Donald Trump, whom it terms an organizing force in squashing what has become a weekly protest among at least some NFL players. Nice try, Kaepernick. Looks like it's back to the drawing board and to find an accusation that will stick. As of now, it looks like Kaepernick's position of playing left couch seat cushion for the rest of the season will be a permanent one.